view.
Hi, I'm Buzz Stoddard with Cruising Yachts here in Marina del Rey, and I'd like to introduce you to our latest listing. This is a Farr 40 that we have available for $149.9, and it's an outstanding example of a competitive Farr 40. For those of you who might not be familiar with it, it's a very competitive one design class. The Worlds are coming up in Northern California, I think September or October, not sure. And this boat was intended for that. And as a result, they recently purchased a new main and a new jib. They're both North. It's a carbon main and a 3DI, not a 3DL, I made that error, jib. And so very high-tech sails. The two of them cost almost $29,000 for the two. The main has never been used, hadn't been taken out of the bay. The jib was used on one leg of one race, so they're virtually new sails. The rest of the sail inventory is mostly, I think, 2012 vintage and a really competitive, good suit of sails. I think there must be 14 sails there, including all of the required class sails for that. So lots of carbon on this boat, the rudder, the mast, the spinnaker pole, and that sort of a thing. It's a high performance with a great deal of stability and just a rocket ship and fun to drive. A few features, and I'm going to pull out my notes to try to cover some of them. One thing I should point out, these boats get delivered from venue to venue for races, and you've got to have a small crew to do that, and this boat's got an autopilot, so that's an important feature that some boats might not have, and you really need it for racing. Let me give you a brief rundown on the sail inventory here. The 3DI North jib and the carbon North main. We also have a North light jib 3DL 2012. Another one that's an 08, and then we have a medium that's an 09 and a heavyweight that's an 09, a heavyweight jib. Class required small heavy jib, a couple of older jibs, and for kites there's a North light 1 ounce masthead class spinnaker that's an 09. We have a medium 1.5 ounce, it's an 08 masthead class, and a couple of older mastheads. And then we have a North fractional in 08, and also a North runner from 08, and that's a fractional. And a code zero that's fractional. We have asymmetric kite that's fractional. We've got new main sheets, jib sheets, halyards. You can see some of the running rigging. This boat is being kept in top-notch shape. It's been raced pretty regularly and with considerable success, by the way. The boat is owned by Rhonda Toller, and you might remember her from a video we did when she took delivery of her new Genoa 57, and that is online. She traded a Farr 30, which we sold, and she kept the Farr 40, but her crew is adjusted well to the comfortable accommodations on the 57, and so the 40 is on the market now for $149.9 again. You can see all the stuff that you expect, such as the hydraulic backstay adjuster. The name of the boat, Wild Thing, goes with this Rhonda's kind of fun leopard skin pattern that she uses here and there. And you can probably, if you're a racer, you're just going to look at the layout and recognize the instrumentation, the running rigging, and how the boat is set up. The main sheet's going below deck, and the three-speed racing winches, and it's just set up the way that you would like. It's not a professional crew, but they're quite competent and do well in the racing that they do. So the boat is set up, I think, for people who are experienced. They're going to be happy with it. They're going to like it. And also, you really, it doesn't need anything. You can race it this weekend if you want and get right out there and have some real challenging fun. Let's go below. We'll take a look down there and see what a racing boat looks like down below. Welcome below on Wild Thing, the Farr 40. Couple of features to point out down here. You get a good view of the carbon mast and the tie downs on each side of it. Also down here, you can see the bilge is very clean and dry, perfect keel bolts. And we have engine access here. You can see the top of the sail drive in it. And the engine is turned around for proper weight allocation. Also back here you can see the engine control panel and also the autopilot control head. That's a good one, Raymarine 6001. And then after that you can see the helm station where you can sit with sitting headroom and face forward and do your navigation. These boats are from time to time used on longer distance races and point-to-point races as well as around the buoys. You can see all the berths have been elevated for ventilation, just a good practice. You can see all of the additional sheets hanging to starboard there. A lot of money goes into running rigging. It's one of the first places we like to judge boats, whether racing or cruising, frankly, is the condition and quality of the running rigging. It has a lot to do with how enjoyable they are to sail. You've got your battery box down there. Over here, you've got your winch handles. There's a bunch of them, a ton of them. Life jackets, of course, three bags of them. And what you don't see as we look forward to the sail locker is sails. There's one jib, I guess they used when they brought it here, but that of course would be where you would put whatever sails you were racing with at that time. So minimum comforts, I mean it's got a head and it does have a water system and so forth. If you wanted to do some cruising with it, you might want to upgrade the galley and a few things like that. It's pretty basic. You got soup and coffee going on a race, and not much more than that. So full standing headroom, and it's Spartan in a sense, but it's very strong, well laid out, and you've got four functional berths, more can be added if you need it for long haul racing. No, for sure. Come on, hold me tight.